What is up, everyone? JD here. I hope you're doing well today. Got a mail call for you. Let's get into it. I am super excited about this. This is coming from my boy JD from J Dizzle Designs. If you don't know, check out his Instagram. My dude does some killer stuff out there, mods to knives, and I'm stoked. These are two of mine that are coming back that he did some work on for me, but he also let me know that he sent a couple for me. Well, I think it's a couple. He sent at least one knife for me to check out, but it sounded like when he had said that it was a couple. I just opened it to let him know that everything arrived safe and sound. I did take a quick peek at these, and I am very interested to look at them because I have not handled either of these before. So we're going to jump in here really quick, just take a look at them, and these will be coming as overviews later on to the channel. We're going to take a look at the Guardian Tactical first. I've never handled a Guardian Tactical. I've handled Hogue, Microtech, and TACCOM, and I think there might be one other that I've checked out. I'm not 100% sure on that, but I know I've checked out a few, so I am interested to check this out. This seems to be more of a medium size. I'm not quite sure the model, and I'll research that to post for the actual overview, but it's more medium size to me, just exactly 4-finger grip, which I like. I've had a couple of TACCOMs about this size. And it is a Tonto. Very cool. Is that it's a compound grind too. So flat grind here. It's got a great looking edge on it. L-Max steel, acid etch and stone wash. I wonder if he did that. I'll have to check with him when I get to the review. And very cool looking knife. Got a nice trigger on it. About the same amount of play that you would experience on most OTF. Same thing that I found with TACCOM and Hogue and all of them. Action feels good on it too. Very nice action. Has great sounds. I really like the sound of this. This looks like it would be a really good EDC. No glass breaker on the back. Instead, it's got the lanyard hole. Nice ergos. It feels like aluminum with a coating on it, but I'll definitely do some research for that one. Overview will be coming for that. Let me know if you have any questions about it. And then we have a Microtech in here. And this one here is the Bravo. At least I think it is. No, SOCOM Elite. SOCOM Elite. No other information on here. I like the two-tone blade. I really like the carbon fiber. I wonder if this one is the, is it Ryuk? I think Ryuk. Or Ryuk, I'm not quite sure the company that is doing this for Microtech. There's one that's more affordable, and then there's one that's USA made. Actually, this says USA, so this is the USA made version right out the gate. So these are two USA made knives that he sent along for me to check out. Jay Dizzle, man, thank you. I appreciate you letting me check these out. I will do a overview on these. Really pumped to check them out. I have not checked out either one of these before. Let's go ahead and set that to the side, set the case to the side. I'm super excited to get into these guys. You know, he had them for a little while. He actually got this one first and had a little while, but his books were closed. So I just told him to hang on to it. I thought they were open, I guess. And he did the mod on this one. And then this one I sent to him more recently for a what I thought would be a little bit of a simpler mod, but he did say it was a little bit of a challenge. I feel bad because I send him stuff that he's always like, oh, thought it was going to be easy, but it was a little bit more challenging than I anticipated. Well, this is my premium Kaiser Sheepdog that I sent to him to do a thumb flipper tab delete and a opening hole mod. And actually, I told him he could do studs or opening hole. And I'm kind of glad that he went with the opening hole. I think it's a cleaner profile overall. And I really love the way the sheepdog looks closed without the flipper tab, but also opened. This is the all titanium variant with S35VN. Yes, that opening hole works really good. And man, look how much cleaner it looks without that opening hole on it, man. JD, you did a Killer job here, bro. I really like this. They got a little static wash on this blade. Very unique anodized green on here. It's more washed down, washed out. It's not quite so bright. So I don't know if it's the higher voltage or not. And then you have the bronze titanium with the pocket clip, which I think they did the pocket clip in a different finish because it doesn't quite match the blade. But man, that looks so much better. Gosh, such good action with the weight of that blade. It is killer, killer action. Okay, it's a little loose, so I probably do need to tighten it. Let me move these to the side so I can get to my stuff and just check it really quick. I imagine when he had to do the work, he probably had to loosen it, and it probably needs some thread locker. Still a little loose. Nice action. I'm scared to over-tighten it. All right, let's see. I tightened it way, way up. Let's see. Action still feels good. Still has a little bit of play. That's so strange. Is it play or is it lock rock? No, it's play. Let me just try one more time. I don't like to go bananas with these, but okay, I think the lock rock is gone. And the action is definitely there. So I'll take this apart and clean it and get everything lubed up and everything. I always like to check that and anything that's coming back in and anything that's new anyway. But let me know what you think about that mod. Looks really, really good. Really excited for that. Came out killer. J Dizzle design. Awesome, awesome work, man. Really, really pumped to get into this one here. So he made a set of scales for me. These are the original scales that came off the knife. And this is my XOM. And we kicked around a couple of ideas for the XOM and what we wanted to do. Sorry, I got too much stuff on the table. And he had a really interesting camo carbon that I wanted to check out. He had the watermelon. And I think this came out really cool. The pink and the green really pop off here. And then on this side, it just happens to have, look at that. It almost looks electric. This came out really cool. Really, really cool. I am really digging the way this came out, guys. What do y'all think about that? Watermelon camo carbon on the Riot XOM. This one here in Elmax steel as well. Man, that came out great. Really, really cool. I'm probably going to do a little bit of a highlight. So these are mods from J Dizzle Design. And then I have someone else that reached out to me about a mod that they did. They did a magnetic mod. I didn't realize how many people have been doing this and have tried this. Like, I posted my video and my shorts and live, I mean, reel on Instagram. And left and right, people reaching out to me to talk about it. Some of those that they said they've been doing it for almost a year. So I have that coming in. What I may do is just kind of do like a mod feature video where I talk about some of these modders that are up and coming that I have known for a while that have done some stuff and talk a little bit about some of those mods. And then I will have an overview coming for the Guardian Tactical and the SOCOM. Is this the Elite? Yeah, the SOCOM Elite. Let me know if you have any questions or anything specific you'd like to know about these down in the comments below. Shout out to everyone out there that leaves the likes, comments, subscribed, and uses the links. It helps the channel, and I am eternally grateful for that. I hope all of you have a fantastic week. Until next time, peace.